The most unexpectedly uplifting and consoling artist of the 20th century was the abstract painter Mark Rothko, the high priest of grief and loss, who spent the latter part of his career turning out a succession of sublime and sombre canvases that spoke, as he put it, of the tragedy of being human. Born in Dvinsk, Russia, Rothko emigrated to the United States at the age of 10 and immediately grew to despise the aggressive good cheer and steely optimism of his adopted land. Appalled by the sentimentality around him, Rothko learned to make art that was insular, unrelenting, sombre, and oriented towards pain. Rothko's favourite colours were a burnt burgundy, dark grey, pitch black, and blood red, occasionally alleviated by a sliver of yellow. In 1958, Rothko was offered a large sum to paint some murals for a soon-to-be-opened opulent New York restaurant, the Four Seasons on Park Avenue. It was, as he put it, a place where the richest bastards of New York will come to feed and show off. His intentions for them became clear. "I hope to ruin the appetite of every son of a bitch who ever eats in that room." And to that end, Rothko set to work on some large black and maroon colour fields, expressing a mood of terror and archaic anguish. However, shortly before the paintings were due to go on display, Rothko had a change of mind, called up his patrons, explained his feelings, and sent back the money. He then gave his paintings to London's Tate Gallery, where they were hung in a quiet, airy, contemplative-seeming space that enclosed the viewer in an atmosphere of meditative mortification. The paintings remain ideal companions for visitors who drift into the gallery at their wits' end, who might be working through the loss of a partner or the ruin of their career, and who need, more than anything else, to know that they are not alone. Rothko's canvases, though focused on the darkness, are never themselves depressing to look at, because they lend our difficulties dignity and legitimacy. To bathe in their atmosphere is to gain a distinct sense of comfort, like lying in a tender person's arms who says little other than a modest, "I know," in response to our dejection and loss. With Rothko as our guide, our pain and sorrow can matter a little less. We can start to rediscover a taste for life when we see that we're not alone in finding it all very hard. That it is acceptable, even necessary sometimes, to hate the smiling bastards who so annoyed Rothko. We can build friendships, imaginative or real, around shared honesty about dark things. Unhappiness is just, as wise artists have always liked to remind us, and despite the suggestions of all those confident-seeming people congratulating themselves in the world's fancy restaurants, very normal indeed.